not been shot at Ford's Theater. Girls, can't you see we're rehearsing?
Sorry.
Anyway, in Act One, we see the poor Negro slaves working in the fields, singing my old Kentucky home. When Abraham Lincoln passes by, one of the field hands sees him and rushes up to him and says, "Massa, save me!" Whose line is that? Who is Herman, the old field hand?
That's me. I say, "Massa, save me!" And Peggy grabs me away.
Yes. Peggy is the slave owner, yes. After you are dragged away, there is a touching scene in which Abraham Lincoln vows that someday all of the slaves will be free. That gives you an idea of Act One. If you'll turn in your script to page 23, we'll go to Act Two. In Act Two, we see the slaves once again working in the cotton field, only this time they are singing, "Go Down Low." After one chorus, the slave owner, who again was the slave owner?
That was me.
Oh, yes, Peggy. Comes in and cracks her whip at the slaves.
That's when I say, "Help out, please don't whip me." And Peggy.
Oh, no, we won't go into that. No. In the next scene, we see Lincoln signing the Emancipation Proclamation. Then we come to Act Three. It opens with the conspirators plotting Lincoln's death. After that scene, which will be played in front of the curtain so that we can change the set, we see the steps of the White House. The war is over, and Lincoln is going out for a stroll.
Pardon me, Miss Jimmy, but why would Abraham Lincoln, have a scroll? Did they use
I didn't say scroll, Ramona, dear. I said stroll. Abraham Lincoln is going out for a stroll. a walk. Now, this is where the fictional part of the play develops. I think you'll find it reminiscent of Shakespeare's Julius Caesar. The conspirators, now, let's see, that's Winifred and Lillian. Yes, yes, you're my conspirator. Only in Act One. In Act Three, you're conspirators. You'll change costumes and makeup, and you'll become conspirators, okay, dear?
Oh, thank you, Jimmy.
Okay, now the conspirators are hidden in the crowd that has come to honor Lincoln. This is the climactic scene. And because it is, we will rehearse it first today. Okay, girls, that's it. Okay, now let's see. Lincoln, Ramona, dear. Yes.
What page?
Page one on that, dear. Okay, you stand center, and we need a step here so that we can get the feeling of height. All right, that's good. Put that down there. All right. Ramona, dear, you stand there. Now, let's see, I need the townspeople that will be will be substituting them for the original speech in the script. Go on, Ramona, dear, I'm listening.
On this continent, a new nation, conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal. And now we are engaged in a great
Just wait.
Lincoln delivered that speech in Pennsylvania, not in Washington.
Haven't you ever heard of dramatic license before? Go on, Ramona, dear, I'm listening.
Testing whether that nation, or any nation, so conceived and dedicated can so long endure. We are met on a great battlefield of that war.
Louder, Ramona, louder.
We have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who gave their lives here that this nation might live. It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this, but in a larger sense.
Lower your voice, dear, just a little bit.
We cannot dedicate. We cannot consecrate.
Go on, Ramona.
Scared so they can kill you.
Say your lines.
Say
inches, and I've had it on for 4 hours.
Stop complaining. Don't move.
I'd like to slip into the balcony and see the show. How did it look?
Great. Except Lincoln's got a big hand.
She did.
Yeah, more makeup. She looks just like Lincoln.
Except she doesn't sound like Lincoln.
No, she doesn't. Just imagine she has to talk around that entire back.
Has anyone seen Jane Moore? Your needs are outstanding at once!
You mean they're up to my part?
Not only are they up to your part, but they've already sung my old Kentucky Hall 3 times waiting for you!
Start over when Herman, the field hand, enters and speaks.